This is the tube digital clock. This is a rather strange device that works on vacuum tubes. It shows you what time it is. It's known as a neon thermometer type display because the little rows of neon numbers go up like a thermometer. Right now it's 416. We can watch the seconds counting. And we'll go back up here and see if it changes to 417. Oh, it did. We'll go back down and watch the seconds and the 60th of a second. This thing is made out of an old Beckman Berkeley counter and EPUT meter, which EPUT stands for events per unit time. So this thing originally had a high frequency oscillator and a big counter thing, or a divider circuit, and a gated system so you could set it up to count how many events happen in a certain amount of time. I got rid of the oscillator and the divider and the gate circuitry and just used the event counting circuitry and connected it up to the line voltage so it counts how many times, or it counts every time the line voltage changes from plus to minus because it's alternating current. It does that 60 times a second. So it just has to divide that by 60 and it gets a second. So it counts up 10 of them, carries over to the 0 to 5 counter. When it gets up to 5, then that carries over to the seconds counter. And the unit seconds counter carries over to the 10 seconds counter. And then it goes up to the minutes, the tens of minutes, and the hours. I had to do quite a bit of work figuring out how to convert the tens, the decade counter, to a 12 counter. That was quite a trick to get it to go from 1 to 12 instead of 0 to 9. And the ones that go from 0 to 5 instead of 0 to 9 weren't quite as difficult to do. But anyways, this has something like 34 vacuum tubes in it or something like that. 31 vacuum tubes, I don't remember. But it uses them mostly as flip-flops. And it works with a pulse-type circuitry, running at a high voltage, somewhere around, I don't know, 300 volts or something like that. Because that's what vacuum tubes like. But it just sits and counts time. Draws a lot of power as it does it too. I think it draws a couple hundred watts, so it can heat up a room pretty well if you give it enough time. We see the glow of the vacuum tubes. Power supply uses a couple of tube regulators and rectifiers, and it also has a couple of solid state rectifiers underneath, which you can't see. The counter modules started out each with four tubes. The ones that only have to do six counts, I was able to take out one stage, so they only have three tubes. Each tube is a dual triode. That's right, they have three units. They have a cathode, a grid, and a plate. And they have these neat resistor networks inside there. If we get some more light on this, we can see the resistors hiding in there. There are a lot of them. The little part that shows the hours and minutes is the remote unit, which I set up. I haven't built the cabinet for it yet, but the idea is that it will sit separate from the main power supply unit. And an interesting thing about this is that the little neon bulbs are actually used as part of the counting system. Maybe more than just display.